every minute of every hour of every day.
Good morning, dear. Lovely.
A baby is born in Britain.
Bloody hell. Come on!
Everyone simmer down just a little bit.
This is quite something.
To find out what it feels like to bring new life into the world.
Pop.
Good girl. Oh, stop.
We put 40 cameras into a bustling maternity hospital.
Back the other way.
Oh, botheration.
Please, Lord.
Why? What's the matter with it?
Nothing I can do, and screaming is not going to make it any better.
Here comes the head.
Keep pushing.
Big breath in.
I'm taking my chance.
From the front desk.
Lady Walker, morning, Nancy speaking.
To the operating theatre. From the birthing pool. To neonatal. Capturing new lives beginning.
She's beautiful.
And others changing. Forever.
Oh, I've just had a baby.
Do you want a cup of tea?
You're rushed off your little feet. We're rushed off our little feet. And I'm here to flipping six. And I started off mad this morning.
Lady Walker, good morning. Nancy speaking.
Yep, hang on. We're manic. Be warned. Hang on.
Yeah. Well, shall we go and see Lydia then and see
what she's doing?
See what she's doing. Okay.
I did a pregnancy test, and it was positive. yeah, we were a bit shocked.
Yeah. Well
done. Hello.
Hello, all right. I'm Wendy, one of the midwives, and
Hello.
This is Kaylee, my student.
Hello.
Have you ever been in before? So we need to see what's happening, so blood pressure, test your urine, feel the baby's position. And we need to put a label on you while you're here as well, so you don't get muddled
just
up.
Just got your details on, just so we know who you are. Yeah, I don't know.
In terms of contraception, I wasn't the most cautious of people. I think I underestimated the importance of it. I think that's all I can really say. I didn't take it seriously enough, really. And you know, that's part of the reason we're in the situation we're in.
See, the belly button stuck quite out. So you must be in a really good position with the back right out, by the looks of it.
I did feel like quite sad originally. I did think, well, having a child would stop anything that I really wanted to do. I thought, you know, I'm going to miss this freedom that I've got because I lived quite a party lifestyle. So it was, at first, there was that initial, yeah, I guess you could call it sadness about saying bye to that.
She's a term plus 12 induction of labour. This morning she was 1 to 2 centimetres dilated, so she's been ARM'd. So we've encouraged her to walk around a bit. She is having a few contractions, but I don't think she's established in labour yet. So that's Tendai.
I always wanted family, but it's you who were never ready, Maxwell. You kept saying next year, next year, next year, next year. Yeah.
Now, do you think it would have been a good idea if we had a baby 3 years ago?
Yes.
He doesn't seem to be coming out any minute. He's very relaxed in there.
He's quite happy in there. But I want it out.
And he's saying, I'm staying here. I'm not coming out. It's cold out there.
I just don't know what to expect. That's why I don't know what sort of help I might give her, or that I just feel I should be there.
This is a comfortable position. At home, the pillows keep sliding back, and this is a comfortable position. I could sleep here.
Next time, I'll buy you a bed like that. Next time you have a baby, next time you're pregnant.
Next time. We'll see how this one goes.
Oh, no.
Oh,
speak for help.
Oh, you have a contraction. That's
it. You can see the shape of the baby when the contraction's there, can't you? You've got good tummy muscles.
Smile.
I see in your bath plan that you wanted gas and air, didn't you? And to use the pool.
Right, so gas and air.
So as soon as the pain starts, as soon as you feel it building, start using it or it doesn't work.
Okay.
Okay? Have a practice and just see what you feel. So bite on it. Nice big suck in. Keep it in your mouth and breathe out. So big breaths through your nose, out through your mouth. And just let your knees drop apart.
Through my nose.
Through your nose and out through your mouth. Okay.
No, you keep it in your mouth. It's got a valve on it.
Breathe
<It's
laughs> back out through it.
Try again.
Is she drunk already?
Oh, gosh.
No, she just
don't call it laughing gas or nothing.
Yeah. Keep it in.
That's it.
I used my mobile for my alarm.
Yes,
I don't. And the battery was nearly dead as I went
four
to sleep.
O'clock.
But I thought, oh, please, you know, you keep thinking, oh, what if it dies in the night?
Yeah, 4 o'clock.
Give me your skills in it!
Good girl.
All right, done, Stacey. Bring the leg up.
What are we going to do, Max, when our time comes?
Where's the wet sign? Because I don't want no one falling over this. Is the bed got to come back in there? You're joking. That's really heavy. It's all these people's fault, I tell you. What's his... flipping babies, I tell you. Anyway, who wants babies anyway?
Just this one here, haven't got too far to go.
Look at this. Now she's pregnant and she looks better than all of us.
My mum's a Christian, so I was a bit worried about telling her things because I thought she'd want us to be married.
Yeah, I was very worried about telling her.
Yes, I can't remember the actual conversation I was having with her, but I said something about having a baby, And then she suddenly started crying and said, well, actually, I'm pregnant and I was frightened, didn't want to tell you, you know.
It was when I told my mum, you knew, that I was definitely keeping it, because I wouldn't have told my mum if I wasn't going to keep it.
You kept saying, oh, well, I want to tell my mum. And I was like, why don't you just hold me on a little bit?
Yeah, don't tell her yet.
let's talk about it.
But yeah, as soon as I told her, it was like, well, no going back now, definitely having it.
When she was first pregnant, and I was a bit disappointed about them, you know, not being married and having a baby initially, and I was talking to a friend at church, and she said something that was really positive. She said that you might feel a bit disappointed now, but as soon as you start seeing the bump grow and the baby's on the way, you'll get really excited. And she was absolutely right.
So neither of you coming in then?
No. I did tell you to bring your trunk, didn't I?
I've got my trunk, but...
Some men do get in, actually. I remember one couple, though, the man was in with his trunks on, sat behind her in that side. And when I was doing the delivery, you know, your hand accidentally slipped.
What's the maximum amount of people here?
Depending on who the midwife is, okay. We'd usually sort of say three at most, really.
But she wants her sister.
Yeah. She had children.
No.
That'd be a good thing then if she comes
yeah.
in.
Yeah, she's got
actually,
a bit funny.
Actually, I tell you what, though, I actually, apart from like, I know it's about you, but I think it will probably be good for Anna because you're so good.
Yeah.
I think it will be a positive
oh,
thing
is that
for
a good
her
thing,
to see.
Because then she'll want one.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's a good thing.
No, I mean, I think her sister is actually more scared about right. the whole process of giving birth. And the fact that Lydia is so cool about it all, I think would be a good example, probably.
Yeah, it
Anna.
Would be. Yeah. What's your sister's name?
Anna.
Anna,
yeah. She's sitting just outside on the seat. She's got blonde hair at the moment.
You'll be all right.
I'm
going to
take a little bit. Gosh, what would you be like for
that?
I told my sister first.
She got excited, didn't she?
No. She told me to have an abortion.
I didn't know that.
Because she's my little sister, I just thought, you can't have a baby, you can't have a baby, you're younger than me, I haven't even got a baby. And when she told me, I was just like, ah, oh. I said, think about it, you know, it's up to you. But I didn't tell her you should have one. I just said, you know, really think about it, Lydia. You won't be able to go out with your friends. I was trying to put her off. I know that sounds really bad. But I think from the beginning, she knew what she was going to do. I think she just knew that she was just going to keep it. Because I think she's always wanted a baby.
Do you need work, Ellie?
Yeah, I'm going.
I bet you're loving leaving early, aren't you? I bet you love leaving early.
Yeah. The other reception's like, when I got that message, she's like, it's not 8 centimetres. And she's like, you should go now. I was like, okay. And then I asked this woman, I was like, how many centimetres do you have to be to give birth? And she was like, 10. And it was just going. And I was like, my sister's 8 centimetres. And she was like, oh, yeah, that's quite far. And I was like, I'm going. And then I was like, Dick, can I go? My sister's just about to give birth. He's like, yeah, go.
Thompson.
Have you had them?
I had them on Broadlands and I brought them down with me because I had to rush down to do another thing down here. And I brought the notes with me because I needed to write up what I'd done with an admission that I'd admitted and sent home. They were there.
I expect someone's
the full report.
I expect someone's picked them up underneath their notes.
I've got a book on the side if you want.
You're right.
Read it for me. Please.
There's a radio.
No, Max, I don't want noise. Maxwell. Maxwell, come and get this book for me, please. Okay, give me, I'll read for myself.
You've got
I'll do it myself.
48 hours in
Don't
here.
Worry, I'll do it myself. You're fired, this is my birth partner.
Because I can't
You're
read.
You're doing your own thing.
Because
come
I
and
can't
get
read.
A book for me from this.
I can't side. Read.
We met in 2003.
Two. 2002
in October. She was the right one for me. I liked everything about her. I think she's beautiful. And I just fell in love with her. I love everything about her.
You're making me blush now.
Nathan, read. Tell me what it's about.
Pornography can be bad for your sex life.
Oh no, Maxwell.
Where did you get this from? Where did you get it from?
It was a present. Read it. Bring your chair closer to me.
More than 50% of married men and women do not consider their spouse their best ever lover.
Oh.
More than 50%.
What about you? Which percentage are you in?
Pornography can be bad for your sex life.
What about you? What do you consider me? Your best ever lover?
Do you want me to tell you the worst?
Yes.
Right, I'm reading now, listen. Pornography can be bad for your sex life.
Yeah, but the CRP was like 20.
Oh, am I allowed to write on your board, Kim?
I'm feeling a bit tense about it.
I haven't seen you looking at me.
I am feeling a bit tense.
Okay, I'll leave it for you to do.
What I'm going to do is put this girl I'm going to four.
Definitely Charlotte, room 6 and 5.
And then we could put the girl in a proper room, can't we?
So she can come straight down?
Yes.
I was worried that I'd pass out because I'm really squeamish. If I watch programmes and there's blood in it, I feel a bit faint sitting on the sofa. Even just going into a hospital to visit someone that's in hospital, as soon as I go in, I smell the hospital. I'm like, oh, I just hate the smell of hospitals. I hate being in hospitals. I'm the real worst. I've been to like a doctor's appointment with my friends who've had like smear tests and stuff, and I've literally passed out on the floor and puked all over myself.
You're gonna feel two fingers and some cold jelly. Okay, like I say, at any time it becomes too uncomfortable, just tell me to stop. Okay? It's gonna start now. Some long, slow, deep breaths for me. Fantastic. Well done. Your baby's moving there. I can feel it just on the tips of my fingers. If it's okay with you, I'd like Joe to break your waters if that's all right. Okay. I'm doing so well. So, so well.
Slide it along
your fingers. That's it, the baby's head. And you turn it round so the hook's facing upwards. That's it. And then just give it a good feel round with your fingers. Make sure you can just feel the baby's head and nothing else. Nice clear water, so that's good.
You all right lying down? No. Do you want to lie
down? Sorry about
that.
That's
all right.
Don't worry.
I'm used to it. It's not a labour if someone's not being
serious. Absolutely.
British women would rather give up having sex than having to abstain from chocolate.
Oh.
Looking for some...
I'm not sure what I would choose.
When checking into a hotel for a little hanky-panky with a person not your spouse, what's the name most used to sign the register?
Smith.
Smith, of course.
Oh.
My friend?
Yeah, another one. Good girl.
Good push.
Keep that going. That's brilliant. Well done. Wonderful. Big one on the end for me. Stingy and stretchy. Okay, and that's
complete. I always used to think it was like a cliche woman crushing fingers on their labor.
She's doing it, isn't she?
It's alright though. I'll do my bit. you have to focus on the positives, because otherwise it will get the better of you. And that's all I've tried to do in this situation. It took me a while to come around to that sense of thinking, but I'm there now, and I'm hoping. I've still got the odd fear that I might fall back into the previous pits of despair I was in, but I'm hoping I'll stick with it and, you know, stay positive.
I can see the top of your baby's head. Go on, keep it coming. Lydia, oh, fantastic. Brilliant, Lydia.
Another big push if it's still there.
Brilliant. It's normal to take about an hour for a first baby to push it out, okay? There's nothing that big's been through there before. Right, so it all needs to stretch, okay? I'm not commenting. Yes, everything's got to stretch, okay? So it's all normal, okay? And it's normal to take that long as well, okay? So you're going to feel her rocking backwards and forwards a bit at the moment. Good girl. Please, Lydia. Lydia, breathe for me. Tiny little push.
Try and keep it all inside. That's it.
That's got.
How might it look?
No way.
Okay.
It's just the head.
Yeah.
I don't want
to. No, don't bend. No.
And I don't.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Oh! Yes, now slow breaths will be done until your baby's out, okay? Just long, slow breaths. She looks fabulous, okay? Okay, and then what we're
going to
do.
The worst is over now, Lydia.
We're going to wait for the next contraction, okay? And then I want another huge push. And then Joe is going to bring your baby up through your legs. And you can have a cuddle, okay? Massive push.
Huge,
great big push. Go on, that's it, you're pushing her out. Go
that's
on.
That's it, Lydia, well
go
done.
Go on, she's coming. She's coming beautifully. Go on.
You think that baby's just been born? Can you hear crying, baby?
Patrice must have had a nice night off upstairs last night.
Well, it was blooming busy.
Right.
It's not busy. It's occasionally not busy. Because the labour ward is what the gynae has kept us extremely busy.
Oh my god!
That's for the night stuff.
Of course it is. Not for all schools.
Did she?
Can you talk to her?
So are you having any contractions at the moment?
Yeah, I think I've had two definite big uns, I'm going to call them. They were made me feel all sweaty and I just had to concentrate on breathing during them.
this morning.
So this is your room for the duration.
Okay.
This is it, eh?
Got your en suite.
Ooh.
So do we know what we're having then?
Little boy.
Little boy. Has he got names picked out?
Well, the bump's been called Jake, isn't he?
Okay.
So I quite like Jake. We'll see what he looks like.
Yeah.
Right, do you want me to go and get your ball?
Yes,
please. Is there anything else you want?
No, it's just the ball from the car then.
I don't think I'd ever thought I wouldn't have children. And then obviously being with Nick, who doesn't want to have children, I always thought, oh, right, he's married me. I might be able to have some cats one day. I really thought I might convince him to let me have some cats. I never thought babies would be on the cards.
I felt really well, actually, being pregnant. It's, I felt all healthy and lovely. Yeah, I've enjoyed it.
You've done really well to get to 5 centimetres. Hello?
Girl.
You keep
knocking. You're a good boy to knock.
Well, I wasn't sure if I'm going to say it on a big sign on the door. Do I have to keep knocking all the time?
No, that's more for us, really, to remind staff to...
Which one is?
You can sit on the ball and then lay the tray on the bed.
That looks gross.
Try and eat what you can.
I am. I'm going to put my nightie on because I'm all hot.
Yeah.
And I'm sort of feeling hot. It doesn't make me want to eat that. Just trying to get comfy, see?
Yeah. Go and get changed to start with, and then get some food in you, and then, you know.
Yeah, then I'll be in action.
Yeah.
So how are you doing? Excited?
Yeah, looking forward to it. Mm-hmm. I figured we'd be in for like 2 or 3 days here, and now it's like, oh, it's all going to happen today.
Yeah.
It's good. I've been useful for 2 minutes as well. I got a ball and food.
Excellent.
I've been able to do something.
Yeah.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
I feel a bit useless.
Yeah, I think it is sort of a strange environment for men if you haven't been in it before. It's, you're not quite sure what to do, and you can guarantee that everything you do will be wrong. You get a bit down the line and
I get shouted at a lot.
Be wrong.
Yeah, that's all right. I don't mind that.
Take your shoes off.
I wish I would know.
You had known.
What time exactly?
You would ask the baby, what time, baby?
Don't you think it's better for me to go and have a good sleep?
Do you want to leave me?
If it's definitely not tonight.
Mm-mm.
Don't you want me to go and have
You're
a good sleep?
You're going nowhere. You'll sleep on Sunday.
I just want to sleep.
Look at it.
I know it looks crap, but you just need to eat it.
Oh, well. If it's horrible, I'm not eating it all.
This is going to be a fun couple of hours, isn't it? Or 4 or 5. I'd never wanted kids for a long, long time. And then, I don't know, just something changed one day.
I feel sick.
Okay. Before we got married, I came home one day and told Kate, I decided something today and I want to tell you about it, but you're going to have to wait until your wedding day. But I want you to know today's the day I've made a decision. She never found out until the wedding day, and at what point I told her that, you know, yeah, I'm ready to have some kids.
I had no idea. Babies was the furthest thing from my mind. I was thinking maybe...
I'm going to buy a certain car or something. That,
yeah, I was. I was thinking that it was to do with a vehicle.
Cheese roll?
We officially started trying, you know, January. And
on New Year's Eve?
Well, yeah, it was.
The 1st of January.
It was the 1st of January. And I was pregnant by the 6th of January, so...
And how many kids do you want to have?
Just the one.
Two.
Feeling all right about all of this? This is pretty much, this is it. This is the room. Gonna meet Jake in. It's pretty cool.
I've been up and found an electric bed.
Oh.
One that was broken.
Yes.
But it was the back jammed.
Right.
And I've got it going.
Oh, well done, Val. Well done.
Please, Lord. Please, Lord. Please, Lord.
Oh. I can see the pain here.
Oh. What?
I can see it's, yeah, it seems to be going up. Going up. Coming down.
Let me come and release me, please.
It's coming down. It's going down now. Going down. Going down. Down.
It's going up now.
It's going down.
Check again.
It's just level.
Check again.
It's going down generally.
Don't think so.
It's still very low here. I don't see it going up. Maybe it's just momentarily.
Maybe it's in my brain. Is that what you want to say? Is that what you want to tell me?
Oh, yeah, it's now starting to
Is
show.
Is that what
yeah.
you want to tell me, that it's in my brain?
It's showing. It's getting up, yeah.
This baby must shut up. Ah! Oof. Oh.
Mm. Mm. It's coming down. 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 Down.
Praise Lord.
It is right at the bottom.
After this pain, you say I'm not doing it again.
But you still do it again.
So painful.
Oh dear.
Depends if I faint.
Right.
And I'll try not to for your sake.
I'll see, we'll ask you at the time if you don't.
Are you not great with blood and things?
Well? Not particularly, no. Mm. If I try to faint, I'll try and do it in the corner.
When Tenda is giving birth, I will be beside her. I will do everything she would want me to do. I will try to make her as comfortable as I can. I'll do my best. Okay. Why are you not taking the gas?
Oh, I haven't got the strength.
I think maybe it's because of the way we were brought up back in Zimbabwe. You only have medication when there is need for that. Besides, if you feel strong and healthy, I believe personally everything should just be natural. And so I'm hoping everything will go smoothly and I'll be able to just get on with it and push the baby out.
Better that way. You shouldn't just endure pain for nothing. Avoid it.
It's for the baby.
Hmm?
It's not for nothing. It's for
no,
the baby.
It doesn't affect the baby. They wouldn't use it if it could affect the baby. They wouldn't use it.
It's okay.
All right.
Okay. Oh, is it really bad again?
It's like the epidural, does it have any effects on the baby?
No, it doesn't, no. It doesn't go through into the bloodstream, into the placenta, so it doesn't affect the baby at all. Okay.
I think I'll go for it.
You want to go for it? Yes. Okay. You're contracting quite a lot now.
Well, I can honestly say I've never felt like this before. Oh, it's tightening again.
Okay, here, guys.
Have this one and then try and get out.
Quite low down.
So that means he's ready?
Could be. Could be one of the reasons.
Come on, Jakey.
Did you want to go on all fours to deliver? Stay on the bed.
Maybe
but
on the
on
bed.
Your hands and
I
knees.
Tell you what, that would be lush to sort of be head up.
Yeah, we can put the head up.
I had it
brilliantly. Yeah, you did.
His
baby
squiggles
about.
Yeah. Smudging
on my foot.
No, you look beautiful. Just looks like glitter on your arm.
You look more glam than all of us in here.
Yes.
This is quite something.
Sorry?
This
mega.
Is quite something.
It is.
You're full on now. 10 centimetres, we're rocking.
Can I try and move?
You've got your goggles right there. So if you feel like... This has to be a boy, doesn't it? Get
the
hands so you can wet
them quicker. Yeah, so you need to really push all into your bottom.
Oh, that's a nice thought.
Yeah, it's very pleasant having children. Really into your bottom. Really into your bottom.
Well done.
What's happening at the moment down there?
Are we coming out a little bit?
Nick's not looking down.
Apparently not. I'm not allowed to. Which I don't really mind, to be honest. I've thought a lot about eating the placenta. I don't really fancy that, to be honest.
That was never an option.
Well, it is, because that's what people say, isn't it? You want to eat that and, you know, it's all good for you, but it's, you know, I'll have a fig off the tree, that's better.
Yeah.
You might as well get your stuff on if you want.
And then hold your breath. Hold your breath and then really push down into your bottom. Keep it going for as long as you can.
Sorry for the shouting, but that's just...
That's really not very much noise at all. No.
You haven't told me to fuck off yet, have you?
Maybe I need to.
So
you're picking it up? Yes. Yes,
darling.
Okay. Hello, my dear.
Hello.
Hello. Okay, Duggan. So here we are, just waiting for the epidural.
Oh, good.
And that looks as though that's on the horizon now.
All right.
Okay, dear.
Thank you, Sister Duggan.
Okay.
Now, but don't be afraid, okay? Big breath in.
Kind of catch your breath. Go on, go. Catch your breath. Don't lose it.
Popping out a little bit.
Oh, yes. That's it.
Come on, babes.
Excellent. Then take a breath in if you need. And push again. That's it. Yeah, this bit's going to really hurt. Fantastic. Well done. It's because we're so nearly there. We've nearly got the eyebrows out. Fantastic. And one like that. That's it. Another little push for me. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. That's it. We're nearly there.
Put your legs right back.
That's
it. He's coming. I can see more of the hip.
Yep, yep, well yep. done. I can't keep him here forever.
No,
next one, and we'll have a
head up.
Wow.
That's it, he's coming, he's coming. Oh, yes. There you go, nose is out, mouth's out. Oh. Come on, give me a push.
Wow.
That's it, it's amazing,
babes.
Oh, my goodness.
There you go.
There you go.
I'm crying.
Where's your cord gone? Put two pieces in
there. Milk it so we don't get blood
everywhere. Do you want to cut?
Okay.
It's like an actual.
Yeah. It doesn't look tiny, really. Oh,
so
thank
have
you.
We checked it is a little boy?
I didn't actually.
Yeah, it was.
Was it? Oh, it is, yeah.
It's all good.
Keep going.
But keep it pushing when you have that feeling, yes?
Keep it.
Yes.
I just feel, no, I need a son. Maybe just someone to keep my name, I don't know. But yeah, I've been feeling, no, I need a boy now. Yeah.
Keep it coming. Keep it coming, keep it coming, keep it coming, keep it coming. Good girl, good girl, good girl. Okay, and again.
Oh,
and again.
Oh.
Nice. Now, come on. Now do a well nice done. Long push. Come on now. A long one. Good girl.
That's the
it.
Well
let
done.
It come for a
well
bit longer.
That's it. Well done.
Push again down.
Come on.
Good. Excellent. Bit more, bit more.
More.
Well done. This is more
good
focus.
Girl.
Keep
good
going.
Girl.
Yes, yes. Quick breath
take
in and again.
Breath. Come on. Come on. And again. And bring your legs right up again. Okay, it's coming now. Okay.
Well
good
done.
Girl.
Well
that's
done.
The girl.
Look nice and controlled like that. Just keep that going.
And
again for me.
I hope it will take because it looks like the battery is low now.
Is it this middle one here? Ready? Very nice. Okay.
No, I've lost track, honey bun. 14 was free.
Oh, I've just had a baby.
You
were
have?
So good and so quiet.
Oh,
well.
I don't think I was quiet.
You were.
You were.
You were.
I couldn't believe you didn't make more noise.
Oh, God, I felt like I was shouting.
No.
Like,
really
mad.
Weren't.
Oh.
That's
really sweet. Oh, little nose. It's just like yours.
Is it?
Yeah. Same shape nostrils. So you and your son have the same shape nostrils.
Somebody said, there's a lady down in the car park having a baby.
I've got delivery pack and towels.
A couple of hours later, I had a bath and went home.
You're right back there.
Oh.
I said, keep breathing, well done.
Oh.
This is what we need to happen.
I'll give it till 5 o'clock. If nothing's happened, I'm going.
Julia, if you go home, I will never, ever talk to you, ever.
You're upset.
I'll give you my last Rolo. I will. Do you know what? I love you that much, I'll give you my last M&M peanut. That's pushing it.
If you can't wait till next week, there's a wealth of exclusive birth videos and much more at channel4.com/oneborn.
Well, next Monday from 9, it's back to the babies. Tomorrow night from 9, and after the huge success of My Big Fat Gypsy Wedding, we're back for more Gypsy Weddings. Tonight, Alan Carr, Jonathan Ross and Adele providing the soulful tunes. Chatty Man coming up.